When it comes to sampling, there's different formats of sampling. There's one format, if you take a note or two, and even up to three notes, and you chop it up and you do whatever you want, that's a form of sampling. You getting little bass notes, and that's sampling, where you're taking fragments of something and you creating a composition. Most of the times, for the most part, that don't have to be cleared, for the most part. Now, when you go into the Puffy age, when you're taking a groove or you're taking a sample and you're looping the whole thing, then that's another form of sampling. Looping, that's like, let's say, what Puff did with taking the most famous records and looping them, and that's a different form of sampling, you know, where that groove is creating your record, but that groove was a famous groove already. Then you have the other form of sampling, which people recently came upon, where, you know, you got a record that you create a record, but it sounds like another record, like an interpolation of the original record, which is another form of sampling, which is that you don't have to clear from a label side, but you have to clear from a publishing side. Clearing it from a label side is when you sample off of a record, you put a needle on a record that you have to clear the master, depending on how much of it you take and how much of it can be recognized and how much of it makes up your whole situation, which is can be, you know, that's what really what Robin Thicke and Pharrell got into it over. I always tell artists, when you get into sampling, you have to know what you're doing. You can't, don't go with the hearsay. Well, I heard. You gotta kind of do your due diligence for you to find out, because when it's all said and done and they come for you, you can't tell the person that's coming from you what you heard, especially when you start making money. And people don't understand even that with making money, because content is money. And that's the new thing. So when I say that, whether it's YouTube, it's money. You know, Spotify is money. SoundCloud, it's not really money. But if you're using it to boost your brand, or if you're using it and you got shows because of it, it's money. So it's just really having a thorough understanding of what you're doing from a music aspect. Streaming is the way. They trying to eliminate hard copies on different things as far as vinyl and different, which they're never going to do. But to me, I always thought streaming, and I still think streaming is illegal, you know? And I know people might, well, how is it illegal? It's not illegal to the new generation, because you probably signed some paperwork that allowed them to do that. It's illegal to the older artists, because these things didn't exist. And when you had a lawyer negotiate your contracts, he negotiated three platforms. He negotiated vinyls, cassettes, CDs. Him and a label put numbers to those three formats. So now when you bring it to streaming, the clause that you might have in these contracts is that they're allowed to put your music out on any platform. Okay, maybe they can, but who negotiated the numbers? Your lawyer wouldn't allow them to put something out on you where no numbers was negotiated. And I think that's what's slipping under the rug that people ain't understanding. It ain't that you can't stream. It's just that who's the sheriff or who's the authority to make sure that artists get a fair shake on streaming?